February 17th, 1963, who would've predicted your talent would inspire me? You was hooping and winning, loved by men, women, and children. You was the best of the best. Made your brand worth billions. I heard you had some gambling problems, but nobody's perfect. They tried to connect the death of your father to you on purpose. I was 15 years old when I bought my first pair. Couldn't afford them before my mama was on welfare. Now I'm a grown ass man, still rocking your kicks. Niggas killing each other, waiting in line to buy your shit. I can still hear my grandma telling me they just shoot. Fuck that, I need the 4s, 6s, 11s, and 2s. Breads and baby blues. I salute you, dawg. Know you faced adversities, overcame them all. At the end of the night, we all flawed. I'm sipping Ciroc and Gatorade, trying to be you and ball. Jordan.
I've learned how to be myself 100% of the time. Either you accept that or you don't. And I want you to. I want to be positive, but you know, if you don't want to accept me for that way, then I got to live my life.
I mean, who wouldn't want to be Michael Jordan? You probably never get this better, Michael. I really thought that nigga could fly, man. I remember I used to love Magic, man. And that motherfucker came through the lane with the motherfucking... He hanging and he pulled one arm, dog, and then he threw it up to the left hand. I was like, oh, this nigga's flying, dog. He's incredible. June 30th, 1966. Bed-Stuy, dad left you and your mother in the bricks. You was 10 when she died. If I lost my mom, I would flip. But you maintained and started the train and get on your shit. Entering like a pit. An assassin with gloves on. Undefeated and winning, building your boxing kingdom. Gold medals turned to heavyweight belts. You wasn't prepared for the cards God dealt. Huh, see, Buster knocked you out, but I blame Robin. Bitches ain't shit, plus Don King was in your pockets. Damn, they locked the champ up, amped up, but you got free. Fought Evander twice, bit his ear, they calling you crazy. Years past, you going broke, is what they saying. Saw you in the hangover, that Tiger shit was amazing. But I still fuck with you tough, cause you came from the pavement. I'm Mike, real nigga, fought his way up and made it. Tyson.
We write our own story in life. Whatever we do, whatever good we do in life, we do good in return. Whatever ill we do, we get ill in return. There's no doubt about it.
Man, I'm telling you, man. Everybody's the same, man. That was the whole shit. And niggas used to always be like, man, when you fight Mike Tyson for $1 million, you can go in there for like one round and shit. Everybody used to say that shit. And motherfuckers be like, yeah, I'll do that shit for $1 million. But real talk, niggas wouldn't even fight Mike for a meal back in the day. We broke too, dog. August 29th, 1958. What a date. Joe's son, the chosen one. Right up out the gate. Lost your childhood to the music. Found animals therapeutic. Remember watching your video right after Ferris Bueller. Thriller. Bad nigga. Remember the time. Classic material. You at the top with nowhere to climb. Controversy surrounded you. But I never doubted living your life in the spotlight. Take a lot out you. Now they got you on trial. But you moonwalk out of court. Fans outside riding with you. Crying and showing support. Can't keep a good man down. Find out you beat that shit. But you addicted, conflicted, prescriptions you can't kick. On June 25th, 2009, with my nigga Rick and Pee-wee, we found out you were dying. And now the whole world sad, cause who would've thought your life would've came to the halt. We would suffer this loss, Jackson.
The thing is, artists seem to get in the way of the music. Get out of the way of the music. You know, don't write the music. Let the music write itself.
Hey man, I seen like real live killers, my nigga, cry when Michael Jackson died. Like, on some real shit, motherfuckers that like would kill your ass. You know, cause I remember we was all sitting around watching the shit on TV, and one of my homeboys like really cracked the joke. My other partner, who, you know, he bought that life, that nigga was like, hey man, when I told you about fucking with Mike, nigga really was gonna try to fuck this nigga up and fuck up a bike, dog. It was serious like that. I'm wearing Michael Jackson or something serious.